What up, guys? I'm David West.
And I'm Chelsea Smale.
And you're watching the 8th episode of Colonial Corner. Hey, Chelsea, have you ever wondered how fast Mr. Burley can eat a burrito?
No, I haven't.
Let's find out.
This is take 3.
Ryan Gilmore.
Mitchell Capers.
This is not a burrito. All rice.
I know you're cooking wine.
Your fast food champion!
Thank you.
What was your name again?
Mitchell Capers.
Mitchell Capers.
Alright, D-Dog, you got a couple bites left.
Disgusting, isn't it?
Burrito's burrito.
That's not true.
It's the house.
You did.
Or just can't house it.
Hey, have you heard the news?
What news?
The not news.
No, I haven't heard the not news.
Let's hear the not news.
You wanna see something cool? That was amazing. Thank you, Grace. Anyway. Hey everybody, I'm Stephen Blenner, and welcome to the next episode of Not News. All right, so first up, the former Prime Minister of England, David Cameron, says he names birds after Boris Johnson before shooting them. Now, for those of you who don't know, Boris Johnson, or Frankenstein impersonator, as I like calling him, is, does anyone know what he actually is? He's kind of just an looks like, okay, yeah, let's Google it. Boris Johnson, Secretary of State for Foreign and Commonwealth Affairs. Okay, so yeah, he's practically useless. Wikipedia is a beautiful thing. He's most known for making it so that Brexit became a thing. So, David Cameron, let's say, doesn't really like him that much. Wendy's or Ohio next? The Ohio. Wendy's, all right. Next on the show, Wendy's is spitting super hot fire with their Twitter account right now.
I hate myself.
Wendy started the roasting session when a Twitter account named Thuggy D started yelling at them about how they only used frozen beef and not fresh. And Wendy's came back at them by saying, "Where do you store cold things that aren't frozen?" Teaching him about what an actual refrigerator is. And then this started out by having people going up to Wendy's and asking them to roast them just like they did to Thuggy D.
I hate this guy's name. Like, every time I say it, I just wanna laugh.
All right, so next up, you can't say those words in conjunction without laughing. Trump's press secretary has been fighting with Dippin' Dots for 5 years. Yeah. Saying on Twitter, Dippin' Dots is not the ice cream of the future. Even one time when we went to a Nationals game, he tweeted, "If Dippin' Dots was truly the ice cream of the future, they would not have run out of vanilla at Nationals." Like, if he tweeted at the baseball team, he was magically gonna get vanilla Dippin' Dots in his hand. The Nationals did not respond, because nobody cares about Sean Spencer. Spicer. Exactly. And that'll bring us to the end of our show. So, if you liked any of these stories in this, and you want to suggest some, just find me in school or comment on this video.
I'm out.
'Cause the Oscars are coming up in a few weeks.
Before we see which movies win,
let's take a look at Greg's top movies of the year.
It's currently award season, so while guilds and academies are choosing their own favorite films of last year, I decided to make my own brief top 5 list of my favorite films of 2016.
Rounding out the top 5 is La La Land, a film written and directed by Damien Chazelle, which harkens back to the musicals of the 1950s. The movie stars Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone as a passionate musician and an aspiring actress who meet and fall in love in modern-day Los Angeles. Practically every aspect of the film has been unanimously praised by critics, particularly its lead performances, direction, and music. La La Land is a major awards contender and certainly a must-see for any musical fan.
This is in your hearts, in both of you.
Yes.
Then I must trust God has put it down. The moment you set foot in that country, you step into high danger.
Last year, legendary director Martin Scorsese released his newest film, Silence, based on the book of the same name. When a priest played by Liam Neeson goes missing in 17th century Japan, his students, played by Andrew Garfield and Adam Driver, travel there and attempt to locate him while trying to evade the local government. You can easily see all the passion that went into this project, and while many viewers will find it difficult to sit through due to its lengthy running time and brutal nature, those who watch it will find it to be an intriguing and thoughtful work. From its acting to its cinematography, Silence is a shining example of masterclass filmmaking.
I pray, but I'm lost. Am I just praying to silence?
Give me your left arm.
No!
Yeah, come on.
No!
When you're talking to your doctor,
no!
You tell him you have a spiral fracture.
No!
Deep breath.
The Nice Guys is a mystery crime thriller written and directed by Shane Black, which combines humor with a neo-noir aesthetic. It stars Russell Crowe as an enforcer and Ryan Gosling as a private eye, who show great chemistry together thanks to clever writing and their individual performances. While it wasn't a huge financial success, The Nice Guys was still highly reviewed by the critics who saw it.
Before we go solving the crime of the century, let's deal with the rotting corpse.
I got a plan. Run.
If you could take one guy to an island with you and you knew you'd be safe because he was the best man, he was going to keep you happy, if it was between me and your father, who would you take?
My daddy.
I think you're wrong about that. Hello, this is Lee.
What happened to my brother?
Manchester by the Sea tells the story of a man played by Casey Affleck who returns to his hometown in the wake of his brother's death to take care of his teenage nephew while trying to confront his past life there. The film greatly benefits from its director Kenneth Lonergan's writing, as well as its heartbreaking lead performance from Casey Affleck, who gives one of the best performances of the year, if not the best. Manchester by the Sea is a tear-jerking and emotional movie, and one of the best cinematic experiences of 2016.
I'm not gonna bother you, I'm gonna just sit here until you calm down.
All right, I'm calming now. Would you please just go away?
No.
The world is coming undone. Imperial flags reign across the galaxy.
Rogue One is the first film in a new series of Star Wars spin-offs that takes place immediately before the events of the first movie. It tells the story of a group of new characters and their attempt to steal the plans to the Death Star that were central to the plot of the first installment of the franchise. Director Gareth Edwards combines fantastic action, stunning effects, great music, a strong cast and a darker tone to make an exceptionally entertaining experience. And while I may be a bit biased towards the franchise, there's still no other film from 2016 that I found more entertaining than Rogue One.
Are you with me?
All the way.
David.
What's up?
Did you hear that Jordan got a show?
No, I didn't hear that.
Guess what it's called?
What else would it be called?
The Jordan Show.
Ah! My dad taught me karate, but I forgot it all. Ah!
This is the sushi corner! Let's talk about California rolls. Let's talk about the avocado. And finally, we talk about auto price. We talk about the $2.25 California roll. The 6 pieces is just not okay. Like, holy God.
Wait.
The cult kind of took all our stuff. It's all gone. Does anyone want to join my cult?
Mom! What are you, an 8-bit?
So with such a big project, it must have taken you...
Exercises.
Yes.
Up next, we have the third edition of Carslay's Corner.
Let's see if Justin can survive her makeup skills.
Hi, welcome to Carslay's Corner. Today I'm here with my victim, I mean makeup guru, Justin! And today we're gonna be doing what, Justin?
The blindfolded makeup challenge, Carly.
This is cringing already.
Are you ready?
No.
Ooh.
Ooh, 50 Shades Darker.
This is the last edition of Carslay Blindfolded.
Alright, so first, for every single makeup guru on YouTube, they seem to start with foundation. So let's start with that. First, we start with a thick, thorough layer of foundation. Am I getting in it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. That's funny. Oh, sorry. Don't miss.
I think she's just put it on her fingers and rub it on your face.
Oh, okay. Ew! Oh my god, this is familiar.
Oh, I don't like this. I don't like this one bit. Come here. Oh, yeah, Monty. Oh.
Blend it to the neck. You have to blend it to the neck.
I can taste it.
All right, now I need the blending brush back. Here you go. You're so aggressive.
Ow.
All right, blended, I think. Eyeshadow. Let's get that bad boy on the lid.
Actually, thank you.
So now we're using highlighter. Okay, so we're gonna lightly put this on the cheeks. Nope, that would Now time for mascara! Woo! Ooh, I felt that was a big curl. Oh, yeah, let's do eyebrows. You know, I don't have any eyebrow stuff, so let's just use mascara. Let's get guess that's your eyebrow. And the last step in the makeup process is lipstick.
So we're using the Mary lip liner and lipstick by Kylie Jenner from the Winter Collection.
Spread that bad boy all over the lips. And that completes the blindfolded makeup challenge. Let's see the results. Ow!
Your makeup is terrible. Your makeup is terrible. Your makeup is terrible.
And that's all for today. Thanks for watching.
Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like.
Whoa, what are we doing up here?
I don't know. I'm sure it wasn't because everyone downstairs was being super quiet.
Anyway, what are you doing this Valentine's Day?
You know, probably hanging out with my cat, watching a movie, something really fun like that.
Let's see what everyone else is doing. Hey David, if you were principal for one day, what would you change?
I don't know, let's see what Leah and Sarah found out.
If you could be principal of MHS for one day, what would you do?
Oh, believe me, the changes I would make to this place.
Probably not have school.
There's a bell for a reason, so no screaming in people's face, get out of the atrium.
I would advertise my Snapchat username everywhere.
I'd make the school day less long. I would make the food more delicious.
Finish paving the senior lot.
Unblock Netflix.
Also, if you're coming in late, just call and be like, hey, I'm running late today.
Ripslinger 444, lowercase r, as in Ripslinger 444. I, as in, I can't believe it, it's Ripslinger 444. P, as in, please, it's Ripslinger 444. You gotta add him. S, as in, so good looking, Ripslinger 444. L, as in, look, it's Ripslinger 444. I forgot the rest of it.
I would probably change Canvas. Because it's kind of annoying that you have to sign out.
No more homework. The school tortures us for 6 hours a day. And we have lives outside of school, and some people work.
I would have everybody have a water bowl fight. Freshmen against seniors, sophomores against juniors. And after whoever wins, they have to buy ice cream.
I would let students park in the teacher lot.
I would install probably traffic lights in these hallways. A lot of accidents have been occurring lately.
I would change the bathroom hall pass. New rule, you just get up and leave like it works in the real world.
I just wouldn't show up to school.
Those air vents would be equipped with speakers. Like in school, Golden Corral, you can have whatever you want, whenever you like.
So hey, I heard Colonial Corner got a new member.
Let's see how he's fitting in.
All right, my dudes, it's Friday. Colonial Corner's going up. Where are the projects?
Well.
This is my first day on the job. I'm so excited. I got here a couple hours early because, you know, I want to, you know, show off to the boss, you know, first good impression.
Oh, hello, boss. I'm Peter. I'm the new guy. You remember you hired me the other day?
No.
No? Oh, well, you did.
The new guy? Carl, right?
It's Peter, but, you know, Carl's fine. Carl's fine, too.
He's something. I honestly forgot we hired him.
Hey, boss.
What the, John?
We have another guy? Hey, man, I'm Peter.
Do you want me to call security? Who the hell is that?
No, thanks, man. Thank you.
Is that the new guy?
Yeah, sadly. The new guy. Wonder where they pulled him out of.
Oh, you need help? Is this cat videos again?
This is my jam. This is
your
like
jam?
This is my song right here.
If I could fall into the sky, do you think I would pass me by? Cause you know I walk a thousand miles if I could just see you.
It's
So the purpose of our job...
The purpose of our job is, let me tell you the purpose of our job, is to make Colonial Corner even better. Not that it's already good, don't get me wrong, but even better. I am so excited. The boss already loves me, Holic loves me, it's just gonna be amazing this year. I am so pumped.
I think this Peter kid's real annoying, especially ever since Derek stepped out of the room. I just think I'd take the opportunity to, throw something at the kid.
The boss just stepped out for a few minutes. It was just, we were bonding, having fun. You know, I know he didn't mean to throw that trash can at me, like.
Alright, Peter, stop faking it. Wake up. Tell boss I'm in the bathroom, going to the executive pool.
That was a good one, Holly. That was a big bag.
Come on, Carl.
I just got a text from Holly. He'll be back in a second. I'll be right back.
All right. Not too long.
All right.
Well, Colonial Corner goes up in 20 minutes and we don't have a project.
Do you have a camera?
Yeah.
Do you have a microphone?
Yep.
Do you have a hallway?
Yeah.
Is occasional kids in there, you know, that aren't supposed to be?
Yep.
We have
Damn,
a project.
We'll bust this out in 10 minutes. We'll get the 20 questions.
All right, that means we have 10 minutes to spend.
That concludes the 8th episode of Colonial Corner.
Make sure you give us a like.
Till next time.